Well, I'm back in Korea finally, and the day after I'm getting surgery. I can already tell in the comments before people even watch it, so I'm gonna say it here now. For sure, oh, Edward, I love you, but I liked your nose before. Too late. By the time this is out, the deed is done.
And also the.
Oh, but I liked your nose before.
Here's the thing. I know they're coming from like a good place, but this is a thing I've been wanting to do for. Oh my god, I turned this shit off. This is a thing I've been wanting to do for like years now. As you know, some of you already know. So, you know, this is gonna come at some point or another. People are gonna try to twist and think, oh, he hates being Filipino. He's trying to erase his identity. Nice try. I feel like my nose doesn't fit my face for me. I mean, I like this whole thing, like before I was gonna film this, there are things I knew I wanted to say, but when it comes down to it, it's just what I want to do, okay? Plastic surgery is not a thing to joke about. If you want, I'm not advocating plastic surgery. This is just something I want to do. What I'm advocating is do whatever the hell you want to do, as long as it's within reason. But I just want the people watching this video to know that this is something I've always wanted to do. I've thought of it for a very long time. Not that it's important that whether it would be or not, but this isn't, well, it's not sponsored in the sense that I'm getting surgery for free because I'm still paying for it out of my pocket. At nearly full price, I'm paying a little bit of a dis I'm getting a little bit of a discount in exchange for just documenting my experience. So yeah. And also, honestly, like, even if I hid the fact that I got surgery, it'd be so damn obvious because one, I wouldn't be posting for a little bit, and two, I'd go from like one nose to the other in a video real quick. So yeah, I mean, and I already have fillers, so this is just a more permanent solution because I've had fillers done at least 4 or 5 times. So it'd be nice to just, you know, stop having to get them. Also, before I get those comments talking about, oh, Edward's promoting plastic surgery in young people, like, one, I'm 25, and two, you cannot blame me for the actions of other people. So yeah, anyway, I'm gonna go to Gangnam Station, and yeah, you'll follow me along. Oh, I forgot to mention, didn't say what clinic I was going to. I'm going to be going to Answer in Gangnam, and I mean, I've been to several doctors before, oh, shit, for consultations, but I don't know. Out of all of them, I feel like he's the most, how do I explain? He cares the most, it seems. Tony even told me, like, this doctor, he isn't really in it for the money. Of course, I mean, you know, who doesn't want money? But he's more concerned about doing a good job. And he's one of those, because the thing is, in Korea, a lot of clinics will go for a certain look rather than give you a look that suits your face the best, if that makes sense. That's why, you know, some people, when they think of plastic surgery in Korea, they see, like, what they call the Gangnam Eunni, which is like that very generic, she got plastic surgery kind of face. A la Park Bom, which, you know, she can live her life. But yeah, with this doctor, what he did was he took photos of me before, and he actually photoshopped it in front of me so I can see, get an idea of what it would look like, and I liked it. So, yeah. Also, tip. If you happen to be coming to Korea, or you're planning on going to Korea for plastic surgery, or doing something here, or even I feel like any surgery clinic you go to, definitely recommend booking. Oh, another thing, the doctor, he only does 2 surgeries in a day. He's not one of the ones which a lot of surgeons will do in Korea, where they do a bunch of surgeries in one day. But this doctor is really concerned about doing a good job, so. Surgery obviously must be tiring, so he only does 2 surgeries in one day, which is a good thing. And also, if you plan on doing surgery in Korea or anywhere generally, try to book on a Monday or Tuesday, like at the beginning of the week, because they have the weekend to rest, so they'll do a much better job than if maybe it was. I'm not saying he's gonna do a bad job, but I just think it would be a smarter idea to have him do it on a day where he's rested or she got some beauty sleep. All right, honey. So this is the part of the video where I've been forced to, just kidding, to mention Seoul Guide Medical, of which Tony, the guy you're about to see, or if you might have seen it in one of my other vlogs before, is the CEO. And basically, they help you if you're ever in need of dental care, cosmetic surgery, vision correction, dermatology services, or like just general medical assistance from like the top hospitals within Seoul, and they provide online services that are free of charge. And who doesn't love free shit? Am I right? So I'm here now. I'm in front of exit 12 at Gangnam Station. I'm here at the A Tower. I'm gonna go in and meet Tony, the guy helping me out with the whole thing. So, God, all that aura is like rushing. Urashi.
Aura, what are you doing? 뭐 하냐고.
안녕하세요.
Look at this. OTD. Oh my god. Here's Tony, the one helping me out.
Pretty quite cool. There
it is. And is it, can you even see an answer?
Here we go.
좋네, 여기.
좋지. 어? Oh my. Oh my god. Stay. Real story.
Nice.
SOS, my face. Okay.
이게 달라졌어. 아프겠다. 오.
근데 잘 나왔는데.
오.
Orange monster.
He's setting up his camera because he's also gonna film. Yeah, this is the doctor's office. Why I'm sitting in this chair, don't ask me. But one thing, plastic surgery clinics in Korea always have these fancy mirrors that all look just like this. This like antique shit. Look at that man right there. Look at him. Look at that. Look at that. Yes, Danny. Yes. Just kidding. Doing great. Now I'm gonna take my clothes off. Okay, I'm in the changing room. Big little locker over here. And we got a little washing station. If you wear makeup, I already washed my face though, so. Take literally everything off except my panties. Well, the thing is, in Korea, they call underwear in general panties, but I take everything off except my underwear. Okay. She's giving us like, I don't even have pockets. She's giving us like sterile hospital realness. Okay, bitch. Never mind, I have to wash my face again here. Using the, what do they got? Using this rice therapy facial cleanser. Oh. I feel so fresh. This room is so green. Anyway, I just finished signing the papers because there's lots of course, what are they called? The risks and things involved. So I'm gonna sign my life away saying that, girl, if your nose comes out like shit, then that's your fault. I figured while we're waiting, just said this will be a before shot. This is my natural nose. Well, actually, that's not even my natural nose because I have fillers in, which you said they have to take out, right?
Sorry?
You said they had to take out the fillers first before they start?
Probably.
From what I remember, I think he said he's gonna put in a silicone insert here, right? From like the bridge down to kind of lift the nose up a little more. Like obviously it's not gonna look like that, but you know, this direction. And then he's gonna kind of make an insert. He said, Tony said everything is gonna be, what is it called? When everything's cut inside? It's a very, yeah, it's a very inside kind of surgery, a very internal surgery. So he's gonna make incisions inside to also bring the nostrils in a little, because my nostrils are pretty wide. Whenever I get nose fillers, I always get Botox in my nostrils to take them in a little. But of course, Botox in the nostrils only lasts like not even a month, I feel like. Yeah, that's basically all the time. I think, I don't know if he's gonna do silicone or he's gonna take some, because sometimes they take cartilage out of the back of the ear. I'm gonna explain that again because my last explanation of what's gonna happen to my nose was very sloppy because I'm a sloppy queen. Basically, he's gonna make an incision here and everything's gonna be done like from here. He's gonna the first thing that he's gonna do was this part, the width, because I have a very triangle shaped nose. So he's gonna like slim this down a little bit. Basically, you know when I contour my nose, I always try to slim this part. That's basically what he's gonna do, but like internally. Then he's gonna put in the, what's after that on the bridge?
He's gonna do an implant.
A silicone implant. And then my cartilage?
And he's gonna rework your cartilage using your own cartilage or from the ear, because there's not enough inside your nose.
Okay.
But there probably is enough.
Okay. For, does she have a big nose, Tony? No, is that what you're trying to say?
I'm kidding.
And then, yeah, that's to lift the nose basically. And after that, because doing that will naturally bring the alers in, but if that's not enough, then he'll just take it in a little bit. Here's the doctor. You can't even see him. There you go. Hi.
Hi.
Oh, isn't he cute? Yeah. He was sitting here waiting for him. He walks in. He just woke up. He's just like, what the hell are you guys doing in here?
Reach. And the tip drop in. And why the relative why the eye left.
Yeah.
Very correct. it's wider than the nose bridge. Mm-hmm. Osteotomy if needed.
Yep.
And bowels to correction.
Mm-hmm.
And annular reduction if needed.
Okay.
And, there is some deviation here.
Yeah, I can see it.
We corrected also.
Okay.
And we will elevate nasal torso.
Okay.
And you like the line more feminine or more mannish?
More masculine is more like straight, right?
More straight?
Yeah.
More straight line.
Mm-hmm. Alright guys, this is the last line of defense. It's the surgery room. I'll see you guys later. I'll see you on the other side. Oh, and also, right next to the surgery room, we have the little recovery room. There's two beds. Why there's two beds, I don't register, but yeah.
You ready?
Holy shit. I was waiting for the NTA to come. And all of a sudden it just happened. That button was a problem, but the anesthesia took a while to kick in. The thing I'm most happy about, though, is that there's no pain. I feel like saying.
Yeah, that's good.
Mm-hmm.
There's usually not a lot of pain.
Yeah.
It's just uncomfortable a little later, mm-hmm. but that's all.
There's pressure here.
What time is it?
1:30.
Initial thoughts. I'm actually not even in pain, which is what I'm most happy about. It's just, I guess, pressure. It's not even uncomfortable pressure. I mean, I've had surgery before, and, you know, I've woken up, and I'm just, like, dense and confused. But, yeah, like, no pain at all. You know those viral videos of like people coming out of the dentist? It's like, where am I? Charlie? No, that's not me. So, it's almost like low key. It's like taking ecstasy and you're like extra nice to everyone. But, the only thing is just my mouth is just super dry. But other than that, like, no pain at all. Of course, I mean, I've had surgery before. And when I got out of surgery, there was no pain, but bitch just pulled out the IV. I was just like, ugh, I can't move, it hurts. So that might change in a little bit, but oh, that good girl, she got crusty lips. She needs that gold and that oil, though. But yeah, like I'll talk about it later, but it was literally just I fell asleep. She said the light was like. Going away, because you know I just wake up and I can't see it right now, but do you think did they take out cartilage from her ear?
I can't see. Hold up.
Yeah. I mean, I have nothing else to say. Even my eyes, I don't feel any. I mean, one thing though is I feel like I got plastic, like double eyelid surgery because there's so much, not pressure, but it's probably just because I can't open my eyes very much, but. And the ice pack, so my eyes are really heavy right now. But like the most important thing, I don't feel any pain, so
she's beauty, she's grace.
She's just
thumbnail. Yeah, no pain at all. Of course, it might wear off and I'll feel something later, but for now, even like, I feel like I can breathe through my nose, but probably not a good idea, but yeah, it's great. I'll talk about more about, because I couldn't film in the surgery room, but I'll talk about that more later, but for now, absolutely no pain, not even like the pressure that a lot of people talk about. Of course, that could come later, but for now, nothing.
Okay, she recovered a little bit, so I'm about to leave. They provided me with free amenities, but it's really just gauze. Thank you, Tony.
You're welcome.
Alright, so now we have to go get the medication. Because whenever you get surgery, they will give you like a piece of paper that has the medication that you need for the next few days. Got my prescription, and now we're at the, yeah, cool. That was it. Thank you, Tony.
Bye.
Bye.
See you tomorrow.
So I'm back home. I remember earlier I was like, oh, I can breathe through my nose. Bitch, I can't breathe through my nose anymore. It's so clogged up. It's just not as easy to breathe through my nose, and I don't want to, because after Tony wanted me to have something warm like juk, like hot warm soup. So my friend got me pumpkin juk, and the thing is, because it's so warm, it like melts the like clogged blood in there, so it started to run. And so I've changed my gauze like 4 times because, as you can see, it's like bleeding a lot. But other than that, literally no pain at all. I'm not comfortable at all. But then again, you know, it's probably just me. But even Tony was surprised that I recovered quickly. But yeah, it went pretty well. I'm not feeling any pain. And a lot of people always say, it's not painful, but it's uncomfortable. I don't even feel uncomfortable. It's just annoying, I guess. Is that even the same? It's probably the same thing, but it's just I can't breathe through my nose, so I kind of have to breathe through my mouth, and it's kind of difficult when I'm like drinking my pumpkin juice that's sponsored. Because what part of drinking through a straw is that you need to breathe through your nose? But it's hard not being able to breathe through your nose and drinking through a straw, so I'm just like, yeah, I need to rest up. And in the little bag they gave me, there was some extra gauze, and you know, like the eye mask before you go to sleep, but it has like the stuff in there for you to either warm it up or freeze it. So yeah, that's pretty much it. So my friend went to go get juk, so I figured we'd have a little one-on-one. I couldn't film obviously in the surgery room, so I figured I would talk about what happened, because you know, it's my experience, you know what I mean? So, after I said bye to you guys, oh my god, you're also gonna hear my nose, like, right when I want you to hear the word sounds, it doesn't make sounds. Anyway, you'll hear it, but, right there. So, I went into the room, this is so weird. I went into the room, I laid down on the table, and the thing is, I was not nervous at all for my surgery, because I was so excited for the surgery, that I didn't actually get nervous until when I sat down, they strapped me in with like leather belts, and that part was a little, she got a little nervous. That's to prevent, because you know, when you're under anesthesia, you might like dream, I guess. I didn't dream or whatever, so, but if you do, you might move around, or in general, when you sleep, you might move around. I move around a lot when I sleep, so that's to prevent you from like shaking or like moving around while the surgeon's trying to, work on your face, obviously. And after that, they put the IV in, and that was a little painful. She was a little painful. Normally I'm not really, you know, a pussy when it comes to like shots, but that she hurt a little bit, but you know, it's a little pinch. So after that, what she did was disinfect and sanitize my whole face and down my neck. In fact, also I forgot to mention, they took cartilage out of my ear, so I have these things, but I don't know if you can see it. There's still, I believe it's iodine, which is normal for surgery. They put iodine, if it was iodine, all over my face, and that was a little weird because after it dried, it like tightened my face because it's still sitting on the skin, so it's just like the whole time. And then they kind of taped down around my face, and then they put a bunch of, because they only do surgery on my face, so they put like a sheet over my whole face so that only my face is exposed. I felt like Gaga in that one performance she did.
Yeah, they put a bunch of sheets on my face. So there's a bunch of pressure around my face. And my whole body in general, because one, my limbs were tied down. And two, there's a bunch of like blankets on me, which is nice of them. So, because it was really cold, because all I had was that gown. So my feet were freezing. But one thing was, they put like the monitor on my, I guess, one on my toe and one on my thumb, my left hand thumb. To like, because, you know, the anesthesiologist has to monitor my vitals or whatever for to adjust the anesthesia throughout the surgery. But as soon as they put the pulse monitor on, I could hear my pulse, like, because during, after, like I said, after they strapped me down, I was starting to get really nervous. You could hear my heartbeat really, like, going off the charts. But I was getting really nervous, so my heartbeat was, like, racing. Even though I knew nothing bad was happening, it's just, like, the whole, like, thing of it all. And one thing that happened that was, I thought was really kind of funny, but I wasn't surprised after, you know, they started doing it, was they started cleaning out my nose and shaving out all my nostril hairs, which makes sense because, you know, if they're going to be working inside the nose, you don't want nostril hairs like in the way. So she was going in, she was like cutting that shit up, shaving the inside of my nose and like cleaning out. And girl, she was breathing real good after that, because as I'm sure some of you have noticed, I have a lot of nostril hair. Because sometimes when I smile, especially after I got fillers, when I smile, the hair would like stick out. So she had to clear that out, and yeah, before the surgery. But the doctor came in at some point, and I thought I would have been asleep at this point, but they didn't actually start putting the anesthesia in until, you know, the doctor had already come in. He was like sitting next to me waiting for the anesthesiologist to do her thing. And this whole time, just like, oh my god, when is it coming? When is it coming? Because I've gotten surgery before, and they do the whole, like, from last time I got surgery, it was like the air one where they put the mask on your face and you, like, you count down from 10 and then you just fall asleep. But this is the one where they, you know, it goes to the IV. I was waiting for that moment, and when that moment happened, she knew, because it literally just feels like you're getting drunk, because your body parts start feeling numb, and then you start, like, getting almost, like, dizzy. Yeah, it just came upon me. Next thing you know, I just woke up in the recovery room. This is what you saw. So I'm gonna have to put on this eye mask for the next few days, and then when that's done, I'm gonna have to heat it up so I warm it. So you know, which is normal for bruising, you want to put ice packs on it, so to help the swelling. And I don't know if you can tell my voice, but I'm getting more and more nasally. But yeah, all this talking is not helping, so I'm gonna go drink my just go drink my pumpkin juice, which really just looks like pee.
To help with the recovery, I got some juke, more juke. It's the pumpkin one. She's so good. Then again, it's probably just because before the surgery, I couldn't eat for like 8 hours prior, so like anything is good at this point.
Bitch, I look fucked up. It's 10:07 in the evening, and I had that like 20 minutes ago. I had dinner, I had bananas and a kimbap. She wanted me to avoid spicy, salty food and ginseng. It's not like my options are limited, but she has to eat bland basically. Because after every meal, I have to take this, the medicine that I got from the Yakuk. And I'm thinking there's painkillers, and because there's 3 pills in each little packet, I'm thinking one of them is a painkiller, because right before I ate, my ear was getting really sore. Like, I could tell, it's the kind of, if you ever had surgery when the anesthesia, when I was wearing off, and the pain is starting to come back, it's almost like when you have an adrenaline rush, and then you don't feel pain, but then it's going away, and then the pain starts coming. So it wasn't like, oh my god, I'm dying painful, but it was like, it was sore, and it feels better now that I take the medication, but it's, like, at this point, it's very, very swollen. This part of my face is getting, like, really fat. Which I don't mind, because that's the look I'm going for. But, like, it's obviously not gonna... that's not what it's gonna look like when all the swelling is down. But Tony was saying that for everything to heal, all the swelling to go away, and for the feeling in my nose to come back, it'll take, like, at least 9 months. So it's gonna be a long journey, and you guys are gonna follow me, and then they're gonna make a Lifetime movie about me. Oh my god, girl,
it looks more painful than it really is. It just looks really bad.
My eyes have become vaginas.
Still feel no pain at all, really. Don't know if it's because of the medicine that I took, but
No, I'm not even uncomfortable. I guess the only uncomfortable thing is my throat and how dry it is because I had to sleep with my mouth, like, breathing through my mouth. And so my throat is really raw right now, but, like, in terms of, like, hearing even my ear, I don't really feel anything. But again, it just feels like, it just looks worse than, oh, shh, bitch. Okay.
Right. What the fuck?
Do you see, like, the inner corners of my eyes?
Oh my god.
I look like I almost look like I got double eyelid surgery. But I'm gonna have lunch now. I'm gonna have more juk, and then... I have to go back to the clinic by 1:30 because I think they're checking out the gauze, but hopefully they'll take all this hardware off.
Okay, I just got here back to the clinic. I have no idea because they literally were just like, come in this room. So now I'm in this room. I don't know what they're going to do. Shit. Oh my god. Already. So I guess there wasn't really anything that they took out, it's just they were literally just cleaning it out. I mean, still stuffy, I can't really breathe through my nose, but it feels so much better, girl. I don't know about this, I look cross-eyed. But while she was cleaning out my nose, the other lady was injecting some fluid. I have no idea what that is, I'm probably gonna get drugged and killed, but you know what? At least I'm snatched, right here. Oh lord, you can tell already though. Oh. Alright, what?
There is a swelling.
She's just ripping it off.
Yeah, it just has to come off like that. So your nose is very swelled, so this is not the final version of your nose.
Right.
Today and tomorrow is the swelling is maximum.
Okay.
Chin, lift. I will check the inside of your nose if there is a hematoma.
Uh-huh.
Is it painful?
Oh,
very good. Okay.
Oh, Lord.
You might speak here and here, okay?
Uh-huh.
Two days later.
Okay. Hi. So it's the third or the second day after the surgery, and the swelling has gone down since last night, because last night was the absolute worst, but now, you know, my eyes are just bruising, so I think that's a good sign. But yeah, I've just been consistently icing my face. They gave me a second ice pack so that when the first one it's not cold anymore, I can put that in the fridge or freezer, and then I can grab the other one and just put it on. But it's really hard, especially when because it's literally like an eye, like a sleeping mask. I just covers my eyes, so I can't really do anything while I'm icing my face. But still, I don't feel any pain, which I'm really surprised about. The only pain, if I do feel it, is if I happen to touch my ear. It's kind of sore, of course, because they took cartilage out, so, you know, they cut that shit up. So if I, like, bump into something, it, you know, it hurts. Not hurts, it's just like, eh. But even, like, here, I don't really feel anything. So far, the most annoying part of this experience has just been my stuffy nose. Like, it's just really hard not being able to breathe through your nose, and, But yeah, it just makes you appreciate things like being able to breathe through your nose. Because, girl, my throat is so dry right now, and... You know, it's getting a little better because I'm like constantly drinking water, but even at that, it's not that bad. So yeah, I'm really happy. What I'm really excited about though is the fact that if you like look outside here, you don't really see any stitches. Everything, he did a really good job in that he did all the stitching inside and all the like cutting. So when it's all healed, it's gonna look completely unnoticeable, basically. And even Tony was saying how these days, if you get a really good doctor, even if you touch the nose, you can't even tell that you got surgery. Unless, you know, of course, you guys are used to seeing my face, because you see it like nearly every day now. So you'll know, and you know, you see this video, you'll know I got surgery. But if it's someone that doesn't know me, then, well, hopefully the results look really natural. But generally, it should be that, you know, people can't really tell. Which, you know, I feel like is a would be a good sign of like a good job when it comes to surgery. So it's not gonna be for a few more weeks though until you see like how the when the nose is like starting this real like heavy swelling goes down. And because right now it kind of just looks like my nose is the same size before, but this is normal because of course I got surgery, so it's swelling and it doesn't look like he did anything to my nose. But from the side it looks much taller. I think it might be hard to tell with this thing in the way, but it already seems like it's higher from the side.
All right, just took a shower. My hair, I didn't wash my hair because I don't want to get any water on my face. But I washed my body because I feel real. I feel like a pussy that's been freshly washed with summer's eve. I was feeling really lethargic, but now that, you know, it's like the second day after surgery, feeling real good. I can get up, take on the world, minus my face. I have nothing else to say. I mean, I think from this point on is when it's just a matter of like, oh, I look fucked up though. I sent a picture to one of my really good friends and she was like, oh my god, I love your eyeshadow. What is that? I was like, bitch, why are you coming for me like that? But, yeah, I think I'm gonna end this vlog here. I'll continue vlogging for the next few days. And then I'll include whatever happens in the next vlog. Oh my god, she needs to shave as well. Look at this. When I don't shave, I look like a completely different person. Okay, so yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye! Annyeong! Wait, just kidding. I was gonna edit, but my friend pointed it out. And I didn't even realize this because I can't see it, but if I look to like the far right or left, bitch, what the fuck is that? Apparently it's normal though, so not worry too much about it.
Oh my god. I tried putting makeup on just to cover my dark circles and bruises.
I look like a fucking dumpling.